Welcome to online worship, First United Methodist Church, Hollidaysburg. We're glad you're tuning in. This is a communion weekend, so just a reminder, if you want to pause this video, go grab some juice, some bread, or those elements that you'd like to use so that they might be consecrated as we share in the sacrament together. I also wanted to let you know about our outreach for this coming Christmas season. We're calling it First Things First from First Church. Even though the Blair Blessings Project from last year was a huge success, and we gave out, I think, about $23,000 worth of things to help people in our community, we recognized it really wasn't giving people Jesus. And so this year, we would like to accompany a gift card for folks, have a devotional for people to see, as well as a DVD of worship that people might experience that together as a family. So we'll be putting those together, but also asking individuals from the congregation to deliver those personally to those who will be recipients of these tangible gifts of love. So you'll be hearing more about that, but just so you know, that'll be unfolding in the weeks ahead. The rest of the announcements can be found at the end of this worship video, so by all means, tune in and check it out. God bless you. Thank you. Would you please join me as we seek God's face in prayer? Lord God, we thank you for All Saints Day. Even though that's in the rearview mirror, we are reminded of the people who went before us, those saints of old who taught us what it meant to live by faith, who taught us what it meant to be sacrificial in giving, in loving, and making a difference. We thank you for those who had the boldness to share the gospel, perhaps in times when they were persecuted, times when they faced a lot of adversity or hardship, and yet they saw that as so important that they were willing to stick their necks out and to help and to encourage and to allow their feet to be those that were shod with the gospel of peace. So thank you, Lord, for them. And we know from our congregation there have been a number of individuals who've passed away this last year. We ask you might continue to give comfort to their families, strengthen them. And Lord, for each of us, give us a resolve to continue to be about your business of sharing scriptural holiness throughout the entire earth. We know John Wesley reminded us that the world is our parish. So Lord, help us to not just be concerned about our own neighborhood, our own backyard, but help us to look around the needs of our world, of many who struggle, many who still don't know you. So open our eyes, open our ears, give us a willingness to do what you ask us to do and to serve so that others might come to saving knowledge of your Son, Jesus. Lord, we do give you thanks for all the ways in which you continue to be faithful. We thank you for the clothing on our backs, for the food on our tables, for blessing upon blessing that you pour and give to us. Help us to not take it for granted. Lord, we do pray for missionaries in the field. You would give them stamina. You would provide for all of their tangible needs. Lord, we pray for our military who continue to serve us. Keep them safe and out of harm's way. Lord, we thank you for policemen and women, for firefighters. Lord, for those who serve in EMS and emergency personnel. And Lord, for many places like hospitals or doctor's offices or those places that do not have enough employees, we ask that you would help to raise up workers. And Lord, as we heard about last week, we ask that you would help for more workers to step into your mission field. Lord, pastors, preachers, apostles, missionaries, evangelists, prophets, people who will be about serving you and spreading all the good news about Jesus and his love. So Lord, we pray for this entire service of worship, that all that is said and all that is done might be to your honor and glory. And Lord, we thank you that you do indeed teach us how to pray. Even though this is a close of that series, we pray that prayer would be a priority for each one of us and in all that we say and all that we do. For this we ask in that holy, precious name of Jesus. Amen.
A reading from the Gospel according to Matthew, chapter 6, verses 5 through 15. When you pray, don't be like the hypocrites who love to pray publicly on street corners and in the synagogues where everyone can see them. I tell you the truth, this is all the reward they will ever get. But when you pray, go away by yourself, shut the door behind you, and pray to your Father in private. Then your Father who sees everything will reward you. When you pray, don't babble on and on as the Gentiles do. They think their prayers are answered merely by repeating their words again and again. Don't be like them, for your Father knows exactly what you need even before you ask him. Pray like this. Our Father in heaven, may your name be kept holy. May your kingdom come soon. May your will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us today the food we need, and forgive us our sins, as we have forgiven those who sin against us. And don't let us yield to temptation, but rescue us from the evil one. If you forgive those who sin against you, your heavenly Father will forgive you. But if you refuse to forgive others, your Father will not forgive your sins. This is the word of God for the people of God. Thanks be to God. Now, it was customary in the first century for Jews to stop what they were doing and pray, pray around 3 p.m. That would be in conjunction with the evening sacrifice at the temple. And despite there being mention of the synagogue and persons praying in public in this scripture, Jesus was not talking about corporate prayer. He was addressing the topic of private prayer, the kind of prayers that were uttered at 3 p.m. each day, wherever you were, whatever you were doing. A prayer just between you and God with no audience. Now, the instruction of how to do private prayer comes from the reason we know he's talking about private prayer comes from a few context clues. We know that this passage also appears in Luke, and there is a disciple asking Jesus to teach them and to pray. Now, we can assume that the disciples are very familiar with temple services and everything that goes on in the synagogue. They can read Hebrew, and so they absolutely can read and know the prayers of temple when they are in worship there. So Jesus is answering this disciple's question as to how do we pray when we're not being guided in corporate worship? How do we pray when it's just me and God? So he gives them this outline of prayer, which we have come to know as the Lord's Prayer. And it's divided into two different sections. There is a group of you petitions, and a group of we petitions. You and we. Now, the you petitions are about God, speaking to you, our Lord, our God. And here are the three petitions that we are offering to God. Now, hallowed be your name. Holy is your name. I would have guessed that this meant that we are praying, God, your name is holy. However, when you read it in the Greek, scholars have translated it and said it's actually using an imperative form. So almost like a command, and it's a command for God. And a better translation is, let your name be sanctified. Let your name be sanctified. And then as we say it, we are asking God to make it so. That let God's name be sanctified. Come, God, and make your name sanctified in this world. Now, the next petition is, let your kingdom come, which is very familiar to us. And this actually is another imperative for God's kingdom to come and reign here on earth as well as heaven, as it reigns in heaven. But you know, we just as humans by ourselves cannot bring the kingdom of God to heaven. It's just not who we are. We are sinners. We are flawed. We are too messy. Our sins of pride and greed and lust for power allow the ability for us alone to bring the kingdom of God to earth to be impossible. However, God can bring God's kingdom here to earth. When we step out of the way and allow ourselves to be used by God, which is the next petition, help us to do your will. It is a plea after we say for God to bring God's kingdom here on earth, it's a plea that we might get out of the way so that God can work through us, that God can bring the kingdom to earth. Well, after the first part, we move on to the we petitions that are about us and our current state of our faith, our current journey that each one of us is on. Now, give us today our daily bread, or give us this day our daily bread. Some translations read it as give us our bread for tomorrow. And that is a little bit more accurate because in the first century, as laborers, they would work for the day and get paid at the end of the day. But if they weren't hired on Tuesday, then they could not eat on Wednesday because they had no means to buy their food on Wednesday. So give us our bread for tomorrow, or give us our daily bread still works each day. Give us our daily bread. Help us to get hired so we can buy food for the next day. And then we pray, forgive our sins, something we all say. But when we read the caveat of the description at the end of these verses, it tells us exactly how that forgiveness of sin works, that God will not forgive our sins unless we forgive those who have sinned against us. We often say trespasses in our version of the Lord's Prayer. And additionally, God does not forgive sins unless there is repentance, unless there is a movement to try better, to shut that sin down, to turn away from that sin and do better in the days to come. The prayer goes on to say, lead us not into temptation. That's what we say in our prayer. The translation I read is actually a better translation, a better description. It says, don't let us yield to temptation. Because when we pray, lead us not into temptation, it almost makes it sound as though we believe that God can be tempted and thus lead us into temptation as well. But that's not true. God cannot be tempted. We are the ones that are tempted. And so we are asking in that moment, let your will be done in me, that I may be an effective sign of God's kingdom. This is the gist of that statement. When we are asking for forgiveness. So now that we think about this prayer as having been given to us as a private prayer, how does that change things for you? How would that change things if you prayed this prayer in your quiet time every day, just between you and God, versus when we pray it together corporately? It's certainly not wrong that we pray it corporately. It's a great prayer. But sometimes I think when we pray it corporately and it's so ingrained in us that we don't really stop and think about the words that we are praying. And how would that change if you prayed it quietly to yourself? Well, when we really think about praying that God's name, we want God's name to be sanctified here on earth. That's something different than just believing that God's name is holy. That's really allowing God to work through us to be examples to other people about what a holy God means. What about when you think about praying for God to give us our daily bread or our daily food? Well, it made me think about the fact that just this week I threw 4 pieces of bread out at the end of a loaf because they were moldy. And it makes me think about how, if that's just bread, what about all the other food that we throw out because we forget to eat it or we decide to eat something different? And so that prayer, that line of that prayer to give us our daily bread and our daily food doesn't necessarily mean to us what it meant to persons in the first century. Because we live, most of us live with an abundance of food. And so can that statement, can that be for us a moment when we pray for those people who still wonder where their next meal is coming from? And when we pray for God's forgiveness, do we think about those people that we have yet to forgive? The family members or the friends in our lives who have wronged us? Have we forgiven them for what they have done to us? And the temptations that all of us give into. Have you ever thought about that? Do they fill our minds and we ask for forgiveness or strength to resist them when we are asking for help to resist temptations? Do we think about those things that we have a hard time resisting? The Lord's Prayer is a unifying prayer. It's one that asks all of us to consider our faith journey in the same ways. Are we living in such a way that pleases God? Are we asking God for forgiveness and in turn practicing it on those whom we have yet to forgive? Are we asking God to help us resist temptation that may lead to sin? Are we living in such a way that people know that God's name is holy? That God will come here to earth and sanctify God's name? Well, not all the time. But this prayer can help us lead into a moment like that. A moment where we can experience the forgiveness of God, where we can sense the love of God surrounding us. And as God continually offers forgiveness, grace, hope, and love, may we accept it. Accepted in such a way that God lives in us and works through us to bring unity to those around us. May your prayers this week be blessed. Amen.
As we prepare for the sacrament of communion, would you please take these moments of silence to confess your own sin before God and to cry out for mercy and for his forgiveness. Christ our Lord invites to his table all who love him, who earnestly repent of their sin, who seek to live in peace with God and with one another. So we come here to our Lord's table to remember his love in action, his sacrificial love that went all the way to Calvary so that we might be forgiven, free, and redeemed. So in the name of Jesus Christ, your sins are forgiven. Glory to God. Amen. We remember on that night in which our Lord gave himself up for us, how he took bread, gave thanks, broke the bread, gave it to his disciples, and said, "Take, eat, this is my body which is given for you. As often as you do this, do so in remembrance of me." And when the supper was over, took the cup, gave thanks, gave it to his disciples, and said, "Drink from this, all of you, for this is blood of the new covenant, poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sin. As often as you drink this, do so in remembrance of me." Let us pray. Lord Jesus, we do thank you for your willingness to go to Calvary's cross. And we thank you for how you modeled servitude on that night of the Last Supper as you washed your disciples' feet and emptied yourself. And Lord, it just as you lavished love on them, you also reminded them of your own brokenness and how you would create this new covenant through your body and through your blood. So we ask that you would bless these elements. Lord, may they become for us the body and the blood of Christ so that we can be the world, the body of Christ, renewed by his blood, redeemed, set apart, chosen as his people. So Lord, as we receive these elements, fill us with your Holy Spirit and bless us that we might continue to be those who serve, those who love, honor, and give you glory. For all of this, we pray in Jesus' name. Amen. Well, the bread which we break, is it not a sharing in the body of Christ, his body broken for you? The cup which we share, his blood outpoured for your forgiveness and your redemption. So take your elements now. Eat, drink, remember. Appreciate your continued generosity and really assisting our church in so many ways through your financial giving. We recently had trick-or-treat hospitality stations in the front and the back of the church campus, and I believe they saw over 800 children come through, some receiving food or a drink or beverage, but some coming in simply to use some restroom facilities. So simple things to many, but you never know what kind of seed is planted in the life of a child or someone else that might bring them here to come to know Jesus as their own Savior. So thank you for all the ways you give. Receive the benediction. I go forth remembering the one who taught you to pray is the one who remains faithful and will provide, sustain, and use your prayers to continue to change the world. In the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah. He is holy. He is holy. Yeah. Oh, praise Him. Oh, praise Him. He is holy. He is holy. Oh, la, 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 la. Oh, la, 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 la. Oh, la, 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 la. La, 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 la.